Okay, so let's just start the state management part, first of all, with user sign-in. And we would be using Vuex to store the data, and then we would be using Axios to make the API calls. So basically what I need to do is, I'm gonna take a look at, first of all, the API, and in the API, if I want to log in, what I need to log in is, here's the login endpoint. And to be able to log in, I need to make send ray post request to api/user/login. And you have to send the email and the password in a user object like this. And in the response, what we will get is it returns a user object. So in the response, we will get a user which contains email, token, username, bio, and image. Okay. Now, to make this request, we'll be using Axios. And Axios is a NPM module which is used for making a get post request from the browser, AJAX requests. So how to make Axios requests? It's pretty easy. We make a request in this format. We do axios.get, put the string, the endpoint to which we want to make the guest request. It returns us a promise. So then inside the then function, we can do whatever we want to do with the response. In the catch function, we can handle errors. Okay, so also we can like do certain things with Axios is we can set a, we can do axios.create. Yeah, so we can run axios.create like this, which basically creates an Axios object containing a base URL and a timeout and some default headers that we're gonna use. So let's get started with that. And we'll be using Vuex. So inside Vuex, we will be creating some modules. Modules are basically a way to divide your store into components. So there's like a module A and a module B. And then in my store, I've got these two modules. So the modules work like independently. So it's like dividing the state of your store into multiple pieces. Each of these contain their own getters, mutations, actions, and all of that. So let's just go to the page where doing the user login part. So what we do here is, of course, first of all, we have added Axios into our dependencies. So npm install Axios or yarn add Axios would be doing that for you. Next step, I'm gonna go to modules and I'm creating a user module. So and in my store file, I am adding this users module. So I'm gonna import this users module and I'm gonna add the users module. I have created a API file which imports Axios. It has got, it does axios.create and it creates an API object. I have set the base URL to conduit.productionready.io/API, which is the base path of my API inside which I will make all my requests. I have created two functions called set token and clear token. The set token function adds the authorization header into the API. So I don't have the authorization token from the beginning. Okay, so I can't do something like I can do like headers and like I can add authorization and something like this. This I can do if I have the authorization header from the beginning, but I don't have the authorization header from the beginning. Right, so I create a function which adds it into the default headers, and I create another function which can delete it when like the user logs out. I want to delete the authorization token. Okay, that's basically API related stuff I put into my api.js. Inside the users module, I have a state object inside which I have got a user which is null and a profile which is null. So why do I have a profile object and a user object? Is that the user object will contain the data of the current user, the user who is right now logged in, and the profile object would contain the information about like when you know when I'm looking at the profile page of some other user. Okay, so like my username is Champion Swimmer on the website. If I'm looking at some other user ABCD, I'm going to the profile page, it'll be in the profile page. So profile is for visiting other users, users is for the current user that I've logged in. It has a mutation, it has a mutation called set user. The set user mutation takes a payload and it sets this payload into the user object. So basically, if you want to set the user object, you use the set user mutation to edit the user object. Actions, so we have got two actions. One of them is the get user action, which does something like this, const say response, or like const user is api.getUser. Now we come to the actual function that we want to use, which is the login user function. The login user function, what it does is that we do a post request to users/login, which is the path that we have seen here, api/users/login. We make a post request to this path, and inside that we send the email and the password that we get inside our payload of this action. We get this response. If the response contains a data and inside that there is a user object, in which case we will do set token response.data.user.token, and we will commit set user, and we will pass this user object. So if I commit set user, it basically runs the set user mutation, and it sets the user data, right? And finally, what we have to do is we'll have to go to the login page. In the login page, I've got these two input boxes, the email input box and the password box. So all I've done is I have added a data function into my view component, contains a password field and an email field, which initially is an empty strings, but I have set vModel email and vModel password in my input elements. So when I type something into this input box, so for example, when I'm down here in my sign in page, let me just run this project once. Right? So, yeah. What I'm gonna do is if I inspect and go to the view tab and I check out my component, login component. So if I start typing something inside the email, you see that this data here, this changes, okay? Okay, so that's like my email data, and it's like my password. So the password, if I want to set something like, so this is the password, I have here some password information, and password will get written here. Then after I write my password here, what happens is I'll check out my action and mutation that happens. So like I write my password and I click on sign in. So the sign in button has a click handler which runs the login function. And so login function here, it dispatches the action users/login users, which means it's going to run this action, login user function, right? And what I'm passing into this as an argument is the email and the password, which of course comes here as the argument, the email and the password. So if I click on sign in, it's going to run the action, and this action will in turn run this mutation, inside which in the payload I will get like the username, the token and all that stuff. Okay, so if I just commit all the mutations, now if I look at my state, the profile is still null because we have not set a profile yet, but the user object, it exists one. So now my user object exists. So this completes my login functionality, although like there would be a couple of things like like this email is already taken, such an error like this, if there's an error like that. So we should basically return these error kind of variables. We can do is take a look at this, say login user function. If there is any error, so like make it try, put that stuff, catch error, right? Take this if condition back down there. Okay, if there is an error, then we basically so we throw that error back. Now that we're going to do this, in my login dot view component, I'll turn this into something like this. V4, V for errors. So if we have got some errors, we will show error message. I'll add a extra data field called errors, which will be an array like this, right? And we'll do this dot store dot dispatch. Once we have dispatched, then dot catch. If there is an error, then in that case, this dot errors dot push error. Okay, so like put my errors out there, right? Okay, so let me just run this again. So now we don't have any error in our errors array, and it just does not show up here. But if I like try to pass something which is not correct, if I try to sign in and request failed with status code 422, we get that error message out there. Something like this, if I pass a wrong message and I try to log in, so you know, request fail kind of error messages we start getting right here in our error code, right? So and then if I actually pass the correct login, I'm just able to log in. Now if my login is correct, what I can do is this dot errors equal to an empty array. In that case, like if the errors will just go away if it's like correctly coming out. So if I pass if I sign in with the wrong password, I get the error. But if I now pass the correct message, just a second, I think just take a look at the network request. I think it's correctly going or not. Sign in response. Oh, okay, so I need to clear the token before I send this request. So that's fine. I'll go to my users.js path, and when I'm doing my login users, the first thing I will do is import clear token. First thing we do is run the clear token functionality. Okay, so first thing we're gonna clear the token so that you know when I'm trying to do my login, sign in, you know, that works the correct way. If I pass a wrong password, I get the error. If I pass the correct password again, error goes away. Okay, so sign in works. Now if I am correctly signing in, I should go to the home page after that. So we'll do all of that stuff as we go forward, but I think this gives you an idea how we can do like a normal login kind of functionality. Okay.